Welcome. I'm Jonathan Hunt, Corporate Vice President for Business Applications here at Microsoft. Welcome to AI in Action. Today, we have a fantastic guest. I'm joined today by Darin Morrow, the Chief Transformation Officer at the Honey Baked Ham Company, to talk more about their AI ambitions and journey with Microsoft. For more than 60 years, Honey Baked Ham has provided customers with delightful food using the best ingredients to make every occasion memorable. And I can certainly attest, today being the day after Easter, so that that's still being true. I overindulged myself yesterday. And a remarkable success is based on a couple of things. Number one, a legacy foundation on trust, excellence, and driving continuous innovation. So with that, let's dive in, Darin. Thank you for taking the time to join us today.
Absolutely.
So as I've gotten to know your background a little bit better, I've just been incredibly impressed. And you have a wide variety and a diverse background here. You've been everything from a retired lieutenant colonel and from the U.S. Air Force Reserve. Thank you for your service. VP of technology at AT&T and CIO at Cricket Wireless. You've been a tech advisor, an IT and cybersecurity professor, and now you've been at Honey Baked Ham for the last 5 years. A really impressive background. Congratulations.
Thank you.
With that, maybe just tell us a little bit more about your journey, including what brought you to the company and what you're most excited about in your current role as a Chief Transformation Officer.
Yeah, so as you already said, I spent 22 years over at AT&T and Cricket Wireless as a combination there. Retired from the telecom industry, had started teaching, been advising and doing some teaching at Kennesaw State University here at the local university outside of Northwest Atlanta. And this is an opportunity, right? When you get a few, years of experience and items under your belt, an opportunity to work with, I would say, a legacy brand and a different kind of area, right? This is a fresh product. You know, it's not a telecom environment. So it was an opportunity for the taking, so to speak. I wanted to contribute. The family and the board is very supportive. So I thought this, what a great opportunity to kind of move the brand to the next 60 years, if you will, and help them kind of not only from a business transformation, but a technology transformation effort in establishing this brand for the future. So.
Yeah, fantastic. And maybe just pivoting off of that, you joined 5 years ago, you wasted no time. You jumped right in terms of helping to set up the foundation for the next 60 years and made the decision to switch the ERP system to the Dynamics Finance and Supply Chain platform. You know, maybe share a little bit about how you thought about that and what were some of the problems and challenges and opportunities you're trying to solve in that transition.
Well, anytime you think about ERP, right, you think about a finance and supply chain, especially, you're really trying to solve two things, right? Inventory and data accuracy and data quality. So we combined the ERP move. I've also established a master data team. So this concept of making sure inventory is accurate and you can plan, especially with a fresh product, you can end up with a large business problem very quickly if you're not planning properly and executing properly across inventory, but also around when you get into revenue reconciliation and understanding cost of goods sold and those kinds of concepts. We really needed a more modern platform, and we needed a more modern platform to integrate. So we established EDI with some of our partners at Electronic Data Interchange. So there were just a lot of factors that went into, hey, the platforms we have are, I would say, insufficient, and they're just not modern enough to easily integrate with other partners of ours. And so that's been really the driving force behind that.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. And is almost a good tee up to the next question as well. You've been working a lot with Microsoft's AI capabilities, and you spoke quite a bit about data and making sure that you've got inventory, your fingers on the pulse of the inventory with a fresh product. As you've been kind of adopting the Microsoft AI capabilities, what are some of the challenges you're looking to address with the AI, and maybe share a few of the use cases that you're exploring?
The two biggest ones were, I guess, three maybe, depending on how you kind of identify them. But like I said, inventory and data are very important to what we do, right? Having that timely, accurate. And also, when you think about supply chain from either a forecasting from a financial perspective or demand planning from a supply plan perspective, how do you get the data to be more predictive? How do we get more accurate? But how do we get more predictive? It's great that we've come a long way in becoming more accurate about what we're doing. We've improved a lot of our business processes, but getting that side of it to be more predictive so that we do get it right up front is really critical. So that's probably one of the big use cases. And the other big use case, I'll be honest with you, is with our 450 retail stores across the country. How do you predict labor during the holidays? We do a large step function, if you will, if you're a math kind of person. We step function up volume, and that includes labor and being predictive and being able to get predictive models around labor scheduling and labor management is really in the next big case we're after too. So between those two things, that's really the golden egg, if you will, speaking of Easter.
Yeah, well played. I see what you did there. Yeah, I mean, I've seen quite a lot of interest and success around those two areas, the predictability about inventory management, especially with perishable goods, making sure you understand where the demand's going to be and how to make sure you've got the inventory where it needs to be. And then same with highly seasonal businesses, really being able to forecast when you need to have those extra shifts in place so you can make sure you're meeting all of your customers' demand and improving CSAT while you do is a huge opportunity, I think, in the industry. Maybe share a little bit more. Honeybaked Ham could have gone with a wide variety of vendors as they were thinking about embarking in their AI journey. Maybe share a little bit of perspective on why you chose Microsoft as your generative AI partner and what you're expecting out of that journey.
Microsoft and we've had a good partnership. So we're on a journey. So not only the Dynamics 365 kind of finance and supply chain ERP, but we're also on the cloud in Azure. We use all the Microsoft Fabric products. So it just starts to make sense in a fully integrated environment that, you know, where we're headed as a company with a partner like Microsoft, I can easily integrate all the pieces together. So it's an evolution, and that evolution just made sense. So that's kind of where we're headed and why we continue to work very closely with Microsoft on kind of the future and integrate the products as quickly as we can to try to bring that value back.
Yeah, fantastic. You mentioned the future being innovative and forward thinking and think about setting the landscape for the next 60 years. You know, the AI industry is unfolding so quickly. You know, 2 years ago, there wasn't a whole lot of talk about it. And then very quickly, it was going to solve every one of the world's problems. So all of a sudden, it was going to become Terminator 2 and it was going to kill us all. But really, as we see, there's certain use cases that are really starting to move to the forefront. And I always like to talk to our customers about where are you seeing the most business value today? Can you share a killer use case that Honeybaked Ham is seeing in terms of where they anticipate the biggest business value for your company?
Yeah, I go back to the forecasting and inventory management. If you think about our fresh product is a good portion of our cost of goods sold and, managing that and making that as efficient as we can and predictive as we can, that just manages the bottom line. As you said, you're trying to get the best product you can to the customer and keep that customer sat up at the same time. And those kinds of things are just critical as far as inventory management. So that to me is still the biggest and the killer use case I'm after.
Yeah, right on. Well, Darin, again, I appreciate all of your partnership. It's been great working with yourself and your extended team at Honeybaked Ham. Thank you for joining us today, and I look forward to a continued partnership. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you very much, Jonathan.